Where's the beat? Where's the beat? Put it on repeat. Welcome to the YuckyDuck Podcast, episode 13.
The topic again.
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 The Demogorgon. The Demogorgon. The Demogorgon. Welcome to the show.
The Demogorgon.
Episode 13, we are here live and queer. Not queer, but you know, just happy. How are we all today? Episode 13, we made it again. Unlucky 13 for some. Mate, put the guitar down.
Oh, 13's my lucky number.
I'm going to start off the podcast like I do every single podcast by saying, welcome to the show. And if you like the sound of our pretty little voices, if you listen to this on iTunes, you can see our pretty little faces on YouTube as well. Just search YuckyDuck Podcast, you know where we're at. And vice versa. If you listen to, well, looking at us, you can also... Bloody, what? You can also listen to us. I don't know where I'm at. Bloody hell, it's been like 3 weeks.
The Demogorgon's in his head.
He's taken over his mind.
So I'm joined by, who am I joined with?
Softlad.
Yeah, we've got Softie and we've got me, DJ Swaz.
And and Vaughny. We are missing Tom. Tom is up to some prior engagements. I don't know what he's doing, actually.
The fish lady knocked on the door and stole him.
Yeah, we should explain. There was a fish woman that come knocking on the door. We heard a knock at the door and Rob was like, yeah, she's going to ask you about fish.
A young man just delivered a lot of fish at my front door.
I thought Rob was some kind of like,
yeah, like
future.
Yeah, come from the future. Like, the woman's about to knock on the door. And she will ask about the fish.
The Matrix shit.
It's a lie. Don't let her in.
That new Tom Cruise film when he's like, the phone's about to ring. And then
what is that?
Jack Reacher.
Yeah, what is Jack Reacher about?
You seen the first one?
No, not at all.
I've not
heard
of any
of this. Get the first one on tonight and you're buzzed.
Jack Reacher?
It's actually really good, yeah.
There's a thing about Tom Cruise, right? That even though I know he's a bit of an idiot, whatever.
He does good films.
He does great films. He's a great actor.
I love his sci-fi fucking films. Minority Report.
What's the one that he keeps, like, Groundhog Day?
Vanilla Sky?
No, that's also a good film.
Yeah,
I have yet to even see that either.
What, Vanilla Sky?
You're buzzed off that. That's a real good film.
Before we start as well, Rob, we've got a little surprise for you, actually.
Oh, Jesus.
If you'd like to unveil, Softie.
Yeah,
I don't know if you know about these, right? And anybody who's watching will describe what's being pulled out.
Shall I give him the unopened one?
Give him whatever so we can see it.
What the hell's going on? One.
Oh, I've just, for the audio listeners, Softie's just handed Robert a box.
Oh, hello.
This is a present. This is a present for all of us. Vistaprint. That might be a little bit of a... So he's opening the box.
What the hell?
Oh, can you also get me one out as well, mate?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
So Rob is just... Describe what it is, Rob.
So I'm opening a absolutely beautiful YuckyDuck podcast.
Show it to the camera. Show it to this one.
Mug.
Show it to that
look
one.
At that. That is awesome.
Look at the black
look
handle
on that.
Look at
the accent like handle in the inside. So it's like all white with the logo on. Then we've got a black insert and black handle. That is awesome.
It's bloody lovely.
Who sorted these out?
Tom Kelly sorted this out, mate.
Mate, they're insane. Of the show.
It's like birthday and Christmas. So this is to stop us from, because he doesn't like the cans on the table.
Oh,
to be
what,
fair.
To pour them in?
I don't want to see any more cans on
don't
the table.
Don't want to see any more cans on the table.
No more cans.
No more aluminum on the table.
So mate, honestly, they are brilliant.
Anybody who's listening to this, you could just...
I absolutely love it.
You could just, view it to the cameras, guys. It's
look
beautiful.
At this.
Yeah, I'm going to pour my... Because we also... Before, we'd like to get all high on Red Bull.
Yeah, we always have, like, we've got, like, a Facebook group.
And we're stink out the cups.
Like, we always have to be like, have we got our monsters?
Everyone has
our
bad energy just stinks. Oh.
Mine is a weird colour.
That's that cloudy piss, yours.
Yeah, no, that doesn't look right, does it? It
looks sore.
Milky sperm. Sex wee.
Yeah, so Tom sorted us out with YuckyDuck mugs.
I don't know whether we'll get big,
we'll end up selling these at all. But now, we can just keep him in shot as well. Let me see if I can get him in shot
as well.
We're at the
top.
Look at that. Get rid of your monster can.
We're Lincoln's biggest podcast.
Are we?
I assume so.
Yeah, I assume so.
There's no other fucking Lincoln's.
Are we Lincolnshire's biggest podcast, or is that
yanking
our chains a bit too
much? I reckon we are.
We're pulling in listeners from America this week.
No,
and most of our listeners came from America this week.
You're joking?
Yeah. It's really weird. I don't know where from.
America. Oh, Phil lives out in America, doesn't he?
Ah, maybe.
Oh, you're right. It does stink.
It reeks, doesn't it?
It tastes like a different
fucking
drink.
Yeah, if you, anybody, just pour a can of like energy drink into a mug and just have a smell.
Ooh. And it also is freaking me out because I'm expecting warmth from it as well. Like, I'm putting my hand around
I've,
it.
I've always said this, Rob, like, anybody who pours, like, hot drinks in a clear glass, fuck you.
Yeah, no, yeah.
It's really weird. Yeah, it freaks creepy. Me out. I don't like seeing, like, the brownness of
tea.
It
stays hotter for longer as well, I think.
But it's just weird what your mind does to you. It's like, it's tricking me. It's tricking me, making me think that this should be
and the cup's always fucking red hot. You can't even hold it.
Anybody who knows me knows I don't like any hot drink whatsoever.
Which is bizarre. I mean, have you tried them? Have you tried tea, coffee?
I used to like the weird, bizarre thing is, as a kid, I used to like tea.
But then went off it?
Yes.
Did you have a traumatic incident with tea?
I spilled it on my cock.
And now I have no cock. It's like a melted stump.
talking about my penis, Softie, people listening to the podcast said that conversation with my mum last week. Well, the last time. Was it two episodes ago or one episode ago?
One episode ago.
Yeah, and they said it was absolutely hilarious.
Oh, it was absolutely brilliant. Because then, well, I listened to it because I went on that show. And then it was the way you're like, right, I've got to go somewhere on the podcast. But you're like, yeah, but David, one last thing. And it was like going on for ages.
But David, one last thing.
Oh, that's what mums do, though.
Yeah, she's great.
We need to pull that video up of you doing the dubstep to your mum.
You've gone mad, David.
Yeah. Is it that one? So you've gone mad or something?
Pack it up.
She says something to you, and she's like, you've lost the plot, David. Yeah. You've lost the plot.
That went viral. That got 80,000 hits in one night, then got taken down.
And then you had to put a warning.
Who took it down?
I don't know. It just got, you know, these YouTube. I've got a lot of things to talk about this week as well. My God. Yeah. I've got loads of things I just remembered. I've been on holiday for like 3 weeks. Wait, no.
Baller. I'm sure it was a week.
Yeah, it was a week.
No, it was 1 week.
It feels like 8 days. Well, one more day than a week.
It feels like we haven't been seeing each other for like 3 weeks, though.
No, it's been a long time. Well, the last one I did was with Jake. And then we did Thursday.
Rob always says it's a long time. I don't see you for like 2 weeks. I go, I'm not sure since Christmas.
I know.
Like, he genuinely believes it.
I embraced you like I haven't seen you in a year. When I came in, I was like, something's been so long.
Before. I remember we came around to your house like, 3 or 4 months ago. Yeah, I've not seen you since Christmas.
Yeah, that was true.
I was like, Rob, I was here like 3 weeks ago.
But it felt like ages.
Yeah, I've been on holiday for like a week. I spent a lovely holiday in Spain and it was the most relaxing time
I've seen some disturbing pictures from that holiday. It's like you spend most of the time transgendering and finding yourself.
I did. I found myself. I rediscovered myself.
Sandra D came out.
Sandra D came out.
Your alter ego.
It's also another thing we need to tell you about, Dave.
What was that?
It's just Sandra D. Well, it's not come up on the podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Sandra D, the time you got a video taken down because you went viral because they thought you were bullying your mum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What else we got?
I'm out.
Oh.
What? Do you want... Mate, I've got so much to talk about. One thing that Leanne just told me, you heard about Kim Kardashian?
Yeah.
I was
going to talk about that and the bear today. Two big news.
Oh, that bear. Dude who got What's tapped that? By the bear.
Joe Rogan's mate.
Was that his mate on the video?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, is that the guy with the video?
The guy with the bear thing on Instagram. He's literally just been attacked by a bear. A grizzly bear.
Yeah, yeah, and he's like...
He's like, I'm just going to get this bear spray. It works sometimes, but not this time.
Let's put it up.
Oh, it did work. So it was just delayed, wasn't it?
Yeah.
And we'll warn everyone that there's some graphic content.
It's crazy. He's like, I'm not going to take off my hat because I don't know how fucked up my head is underneath this. He says, I think my ears are like...
You see that big stitch he had down the side of his head?
I ain't seen the aftermath. I just saw, he literally posted it straight to Instagram. Which is funny. It's like, I've just been attacked by a bear. Let me quickly post this on Instagram.
Look how chillaxed he is as well.
I haven't seen this.
Do you reckon he played dead?
I haven't seen this. I only saw, the...
Ta-da. Yeah, he's been on... ta-da.
They got him on Rogan.
His name's Ta-da. Ta-da!
Ta-da.
Let's have a look.
Yeah, he's been on Rogan.
Just had a grizzly with two cubs.
Oh my God, look at his face.
Come at me from about 80 yards.
Look at that.
And I sprayed the out of her with bear spray.
Oh shit, and look at his head.
On my face and protected the back of my neck. She got my head good. I don't know what's under my hat. Oh. My ear. My arm.
His adrenaline's going though, isn't it?
Oh,
is that bone?
Yeah. Out. I don't know what's going on in there.
A hole in his arm.
And then my shoulder, it's ripped up. I think my arm's broke, but legs are good.
I think he's still buzzing off adrenaline right
Eyes
there.
Are good.
You won't feel the pain for another hour.
I walked out 3 miles. Now
oh, shit, he's walked three miles?
Be safe out there.
My
God. Spray doesn't always work. but it's better than nothing.
What? No shit, it didn't work.
That's crazy. That's absolutely
I think
crazy.
It did work, didn't it? But it was like delayed on the burn or something.
And
it,
also,
like,
it
left
like,
him after it started burning.
It's like a mama bear with two cubs. She's just going to be even more enraged. Crazy.
Baby ones are keen as fuck to see anything. It would have been like his fault. I bet the mum didn't even see him. Because grizzlies may be quite good if you're near them. As long as you're not pestering them or getting near the babies. But as soon as the kids will just want to investigate you.
And then
the mums will just be like,
yeah, she's
nah, mate.
Wired up then, isn't she? On his Instagram, it was when I saw it, it was like 6 o'clock this morning, but I was like, look at this. And then two pictures before that, he says, oh, for some perspective on it, here's a bear claw, a grizzly bear claw. And I'm not kidding you, it was like that wide. It was like a foot and a half wide. Like, so imagine that swiping your fucking head. Like, there's a picture of him holding up a bear claw.
He said, like, he was protecting the back of his neck or big. Some shit. Does bears normally go...
I think it's like a... Well, I don't know. I have to be careful with some things I say because I just make a bullshit mess.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm pretty sure going for the neck is quite a like a predatorial thing, isn't it? We see, like, lions go for, like, antelope. It's straight for the jugular.
Yeah, jugular, slit it open. I mean, they know what they're doing.
I'm pretty sure bears do it as well. And, like, wolves, they all go for this.
Do you ever see the...
That's like the... Well, it's just... All your airways there, isn't it?
Oh,
one
God.
Bite of that, you're done.
But they were just, like, yeah, I mean, wild animals and that. The thing is with them, though, they don't, like if we go hunting and that, we shoot and kill an aim for the head or whatever, yeah, just so they're dead straight away. Animals, they're just going
to
eat you alive.
Especially bears, they're
just
going to
go
before they kill
you
as well. Apparently, I've heard that.
You're going to be laid there and it's going to be eating you, like, fuck.
Yeah.
Brutal. Nature's brutal.
I wonder why the back... Do you reckon it's because it's, like, they can... Because instinctively, animals are quite smart, aren't they? Do you reckon it's because it's like closest to your head and it's quite like jaw
Why
width.
The back of your neck? You think the front of your neck, wouldn't it?
It's jaw width, isn't it, for an animal like that? Like.
Do you not think with that, though, it's just accidental, just swipe. He happens to be stood back to her because he's like cowling down and it's just been swiped. I don't think she's gone, hang on, I'm going to pop him off at the back of the neck. Duck, weave, slash.
I don't know because I'm pretty sure. I'm not saying I make up bullshit, but I usually hear something and forget half of it. But I'm pretty sure that... Predatory animals. Oh, he's a bear predator. They are big. Yeah. Do they go?
It's not exactly
it's not like cats,
yogi,
are they? Yeah. They're
well,
not
apparently
like big
they have,
cats.
They're the sole predator. They haven't got anything that's going to attack them except for human beings.
Oh yeah, they rule.
So they rule the.
They
roost.
Rule like yeah the woods out in America, don't they? Well, and. Well, to be fair, there are other animals that live side by side, aren't there? I'm sure there's certain parts of America where there's bears and wolves. And cats, don't
yeah,
they have like cougars
wolves?
And stuff?
Yeah, big
fuck
cats,
about
yeah.
with bears.
Which live near bears. Yeah, but
I reckon cougars would more fuck with a bear. Well, there's a picture of a bear fighting a moose or some shit. Because moose are meant to be hard as fuck. Man,
yeah,
honestly.
Like they're huge.
They're massive antlers that grow out their heads. You're not fucking with those guys.
Oh shit, did you see that thing on the news like a week ago when 300 deers got like. Died on the spot because a lightning strike
yeah,
came
yeah,
down.
Yeah. Oh yeah, it's real dark.
And there's fucking just dead deers everywhere. Fuck, that's fucked.
It's a bit like that football. You ever seen that happen to humans on the football field?
No,
you've not seen that.
Can that happen? Because like, yep. Do they not have rubber studs?
You just remind
you
me
guys
of
keep
do you remember that Angel of Death video and that guy like has a.
Oh, don't. I was thinking about that. That's so weird. I was thinking about that. Should we show Robin? No. Is it fucked up? I don't like looking at fucked up shit.
It's the music to it, and it's like.
No, I don't like the sound of it.
Basically, describe what happens to Rob.
Okay,
because
I don't
anybody
see
who's
this
never.
Shit,
okay,
seen
so
this
basically, this guy's on a football pitch, and I don't know. I've hit. Did that dude die? He was alive, right, wasn't he, afterwards?
I don't know whether I seem to remember thinking I heard that he died, but I don't know.
I'm sure there's that video of the guy at the footy player just has a heart attack on the pitch, isn't there?
Just describe it, because we don't know what we're on about.
Okay,
I know
sorry,
what I was on about.
Okay, so basically, they called it the Angel of Death. Because
I don't know why.
Because
he looks like he's possessed, basically.
Yeah, he like, he hits
so
his
where
head.
Are we? Where are we?
We're in okay, football, football pitch, we're all looking down, and football player, he's one of the players on the pitch. And I can't remember whether he hits his head or we'll find out when we watch it. But he
am
just
I
starts.
It up? Okay.
But he just starts running. He just.
It's not funny, but it is.
It is funny because it's. Like, yeah. I'm pretty sure he didn't die this one. But he hit his head and he starts running backwards, like his eyes in the back of his head, like running backwards.
He's
like hopping and doing roly polies backwards, like and he's going nuts. Like he's got like spasms.
But he's having like spasms and shit. And
oh,
he's like, and
does it look a bit?
But
it
the
looks
video,
weird.
The video they originally posted was so fucked up. They put this like music. They called it Angel of Death.
Oh, no, I just saw that. Has anyone, like, put weird music?
You should have put Angel of Death Football, because that's got the fucked up... Oh, you did put it?
Yeah, I did. Maybe it is this one. Should I have a look?
Yeah, see if it's got the music, because the music was what fucked... Yeah?
Watch him go, look. Look at him, Rob.
What the fuck? He actually... Look at his teammates, like, are you all right?
You're right, pal. Does it play again?
Dude, that second bit when he stands up. Go back, like, there. When he gets that bit there, when he gets on that bit.
It's like The Exorcist.
It wasn't backwards, though.
Oh, it's like The Exorcist. What is going on with it?
The music. Oh, that bit there.
Oh, let's just go back a little bit more. Yeah, basically, for anyone's listening, he's just flipping around like
on this football pitch. Kind
of they got it, the Angel of Death.
Yeah, just search.
He tracked like a nerve, and it's like making him death drop. Have you seen the death drops? The dancing that's like a craze in New York and stuff. Death drops. It's basically like loads of like transgender and like
death drops.
Yeah, it's called.
Do
death
they get
drop.
All like sexy with it?
No, they literally storm up and down dancing, and then they drop and bend their knees backwards like that, and then just slam and then get back up. It's called like death dropping or something. Like, it's hilarious.
They can like bend all the way backwards and come back up again, can't they?
Yeah, but they're like literally all like glammed up and stuff, and then just like slamming the body down. It's wicked. When we went out, we tried to death drop. But you're going to pop a kneecap out doing that shit. You've got to limber up before.
Get back up again.
No, I don't know. I think I saw someone on like X Factor like last year doing a death drop.
There's loads of death drops.
Oh, here we go. Yeah, it's that like, it's like an actual, yeah, that's it, death drops.
Was it?
Yeah,
oh,
that's
yeah,
it. And you like bend your knee there, look. Boom!
Yeah, you could slam the back of your head though.
Mate. But yeah, it's really big in the gay and transgender shit. That's the kind of shit that I was talking about.
Look at
yeah, look.
Leg snap.
It looks like they're being yanked by some kind of force.
How do they not hurt themselves doing that?
I don't know. You I think I saw it on RuPaul's Drag Race. That's where I probably saw it first.
Oh, the leg just makes me feel like
boom!
Boom!
Nulling, I'm out.
Oh, shit, I went really loud then.
You have to be real committed to a fucking dance to land on the back of your fucking head.
Yeah,
and nearly knock yourself out.
But for that to be a style of dance, like a new, like, so you've got like
how many stupid styles of dancing is there?
Like how many what?
Well, I want to say not stupid styles of dancing, but moves, right? Because at the minute there's this thing called a dab, which everybody does. You know,
I've not got on board with that.
But you know,
13-year-old white kids.
Do you know what dabbing is? Because I'm saying this to Tom. Do you know what dabbing is the equivalent of? It's when we used to do that.
Yeah, isn't it? Yeah.
You know, for anyone listening, do you ever was that just an English thing? Where you used to snap your fingers like Ali G? Like,
yeah, Ali G thing. That's the first time I saw it. I mean, I don't know if he created that or where would that even come from?
I don't know. I have no idea.
I remember that being around before Ali. I think it's just something he nicked off like absolute chav bobs in the day.
The thing is, it used to really fucking hurt. Like when I was learning to do it.
Isn't it weird how little things like that like catch on? Like as if that catches on, someone doing that like spreads around the whole of the world.
There's a video, you know the Minecom video. You ever seen that Minecom?
Oh, there's a new one, isn't there?
Dedicated Wham.
What did the dedicated Wham?
There's so many kids at this Minecom just doing dabs after the like. There's a panel of like.
Have you seen it, the Minecon thing?
No. Oh, what's basically, Minecon?
They're like...
Minecraft.
Without putting any illness... Well, not illness, but like disability. They're all very autistic.
Okay. Basically, the biggest the biggest room of autistic people we've ever seen.
Yeah.
They might as well call it autistic.
They're all dabbing.
And they ask like the most awkward questions. Like one of them's like, how many of you have autism? And is it like... And they're like, we can't answer that question. Like, it's so awkward. They ask the most awkward shit.
And it's only little kids. I don't know why you're getting little kids to ask like questions anyway, because they don't ask any like relative questions.
You have to get the dedicated rabbit. His fucking hat that he's wearing.
Oh, yeah,
you
know,
why did no dedicated web?
Has Rob never seen that? I mean, I hate to pull the clips.
There's a new one,
Tom.
Isn't there?
Oh, because there's a guy
Yeah, sorry, Tom.
Yeah, but if Rob hasn't seen that, dedicated
Wham.
Have you seen that other video that's been going viral? And I think I'm a bit late to it. And I found it on Friday night on Facebook. Which and then I haven't been able to stop listening to it. And I'll be
God,
in the
I know exactly what
and
you're
And I've
about
been
to
in
say.
The toilet. And then it'll start like, do, 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 do. Is that apple
pineapple
pen?
Yeah, he's like, I have an apple.
I have a pen.
Apple pen.
I have a pineapple.
I have a pen.
Pineapple apple pear.
Oh, yeah, then he mixes the both of them, doesn't he?
Pineapple apple pear.
Pineapple apple
pear. That's it. Pineapple pineapple pear.
I mean, how did he see
it? Have you seen it with
viral?
The Drake video, though? They've like put it over the Drake video, and that's what gets
oh,
me.
Oh, he's nailed it, yeah.
Oh, my God, because his little dancing like that. How much hype has that, or exposure has that Drake video got, that Hotline Bling video? That must have been seen over like 40 billion
one?
Times.
Oh, the...
The pink room where he's doing Hotline that weird
Bling.
Dancing.
Yeah. Thing is, though, everyone's murked him for that song. I really like that song. His new stuff I fucking hate.
Well... The hips on my waist thing, I hated it. Didn't
oh, that's
understand
quite good.
Why it was number one for so long. And then after like 8 weeks of hearing it, it clicked in my head and went, shit, I like this song.
Yeah, dude, when I first heard it, I was a little bit odd.
Is that the one that goes, I don't need no one. I don't need no one.
I think it takes 8 weeks to get into your head.
Yeah. So, yeah, just, I just, I'm not a big fan of his, like, controller. Undo the boulder. Like, just, that voice really annoys me. The way he like skips with his
like,
words.
Sounds like you're on about The Weeknd, though.
No.
You heard The Weeknd and Daft Punk's new song.
Yeah, I'm not a fan of
no,
that.
Neither
yeah.
am I.
I listened to it, I was like, pop song. Yeah.
I wonder if it's just okay. a clash of the two, because they're both great, but together they wasn't very good.
Have you seen The Weeknd in interviews, though?
No.
I just can't get
proper
past the
awkward
hair,
mother.
Is he?
I think he's just purposely being, I don't know, mate, but I saw him in one interview, I've probably been really harsh to him, but... I was just unsold and I was like, come on,
some
mate.
People just can't do media like that, though. Like Tom Hardy, I've seen him on Jonathan Ross, and he just seemed like, I love Tom Hardy, but like he was getting interviewed by Jonathan Ross, and it was just like, he was like dark behind the eyes, and like he was just like, yeah, no, no. And he just wasn't given anything. And I think some people just want to be an actor or want to be a performer.
Yeah, not
they
have
don't
all the
want the bullshit.
They tried to play out Tom Hardy's being a dick in that, but it didn't turn out he'd murked Tom Hardy. Like prior to it, or something.
Probably
like
if it was Jonathan Ross, like you,
yeah, and he was just like, I don't really like Jonathan Ross, pretty much. So he just was a bit of an asshole. And
Britney Spears was on Jonathan Ross on Friday night. I like
is she making a comeback? Or
yeah,
what?
She
what's
is,
going
yeah.
on with her?
She looked pretty hot to be fair. She looked smoking. She was a good laugh as well. Although she was very much like, yes, yes. And I was like, she's gone through some shit.
She
you
not looking
tell.
Haggard yet.
No, she looks hot, mate.
Let's have a look.
Yeah, she did look hot.
I thought no, she'd be know. Looking fucking
she looked
kind of
like old
now.
School. Oh, she me. Buzzed her head off.
Britney Spears, what is it, 2015?
It's 16.
20.
I don't know what year
you're in. What was it, 2015, mate?
Oh, she's all right.
Yeah, she looks.
She
got this really
now.
Cute nose thing going on. I said to Laura, I was like, look at her nose and like the bridge of her eyebrow. She looks kind of like a lioness. And she looked pretty smoking. Hang on, is that her with a bald head? That
I think she looks hotter one? Now than she did
up,
when
up,
she...
Up, 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 up. No.
Hey, my fucking nose is doing my day.
Rob, where is it, mate?
Go up.
I can't see it.
Go up, right. You're right. No, look the other way. Keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going, keep going. Down. And there. The other one. That's it. Oh, no. It's just, oh.
No, she's a hair tie back. She's not bad. I think she's definitely aged well.
I think, yeah, I think she looks better now.
She's got the mum
again,
of two.
How much is that, like,
I never thought she was hot when she was
Botox.
I didn't know she had two kids.
I wasn't the biggest fan of
no, I wasn't.
Spears.
Now she looks... I think now she looks babe.
She's, like, mummy hot. Do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Mature hot.
Good size as well. She's a bit curvy now.
Oh, that's God, what is that?
How old do you think she is? We had a little debate about how old we thought she is. Some people said 45. Some people said, like... early 30s. Some people said mid 30s. Because it feels like she's been around forever, Britney Spears.
I think
what would you
I
guess
think, I think like 38, something like that. I don't think she's hit 40s yet.
What do you say?
Let me have a look. Cause I'm good with ages. I don't know. I reckon she's 39.
I'd say 38.
Look well, it up. I'm pretty sure it was mid 30s.
Look it up.
Let's have a look.
Because in my head, I feel like she would be like 40 because she's been on the scene so long. But then... I mean, I was surprised.
She's
34.
34. Look.
What? That's crazy. I would.
It's thought. Like she's been like preserved.
Been preserved
for 2016. Look, Britney's gone crazy. She shaved off her hair. We need to preserve her.
We need to preserve her.
We need to bring her back out in 2016 when music's gone wrong.
Well, I thought she's gonna have like another full breakdown.
Yeah,
she but then again, I don't know. That's a good point because she did like go really wrong when she shaved her head.
But like, let's link this into Kardashian. Like, imagine how fucked it up it is being that famous and that rich and not being able to trust anyone except for probably your closest family and your husband.
Like, but we touch upon this a lot, don't we? We say just everyone's like a yes woman or man to you. Everyone around you will pretty much say yes.
It must fuck with your head. I mean, these robbers, like, it must be an inside job. They must know.
Oh, you want about, we're rewinding back to King Kardashian.
Yeah, I was linking it in. I was going to link it in with it. Yeah, because, like, I was thinking about King Kardashian. Like, who can she trust? Like, she's got a family. Her entourage are probably just around her because they're... she's got 7 million's worth of fucking jewellery hanging around.
It's in Paris as well. As soon as Leanne told me, I was like, oh, shit, it's probably some kind of terrorist attack.
Taking out Kardashian.
Fucking after the French at the moment, aren't they? They want a piece of the French.
Mate, for sure.
I kind of think it's sad or whatever. I don't really like Kim Kardashian, but I'm not going to make it.
No, I think it's sad. I mean, who wants a gun?
Do you not hear about that soldier that was on a night out and he walked home?
He's gone missing,
yeah.
Yeah, that's sad.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah, but they found his phone in a garbage truck, like 10 miles away from where it last was. So, fuck knows what's going on with that.
I haven't even heard about
like
that.
Like 10 miles away or 20 miles away, someone tried to basically kidnap two soldiers a bit ago.
Yeah. Do you know what the world is actually fucked up? Like, I saw on, I think it's like the Lincoln Night.
I can't lean back with this.
On the Lincoln Night or something like that, that local, like a 14-year-old boy is walking home from school. 14-year-old boy is walking home from school, and five men in a black transit van tried to drag him into the black transit van.
Five men?
Yeah, for one 14-year-old boy.
I think we've spoken about this before, but I never understood how five of the same psychopath meet.
Yeah, that
it's
is
so
fucked
rare.
Up, like, isn't it?
That's what I think as well.
I think that's so odd. Like, it's hard enough to find one person that would steal
unless
a child.
Unless they're, like, indoctrinating each other, kind of like the terrorism thing.
Well, it's like group
they
mentality.
All vibe off each other, like, oh, yeah, we think this about the world, and, yeah, they're bad on us. And
yeah. They're the kind of things that
egg themselves into it.
Who eggs it on first?
Yeah, but like...
It's obviously an instigator.
Somebody preys onto the weak.
Yeah, yeah.
We say that, but now it's like... Now we're more connected more than ever. I bet it's way easier to find.
Yeah, I mean, you go on a...
I bet you could just Google forum. I need three dudes to go steal some babies, and I bet you'd find three dudes in like an hour.
Steal babies. Babystealers.com.
Three baby stealers.
It's wrong, isn't it? I mean, did you watch the Jimmy Savile programme last night?
Oh, was it last night?
Yeah, it was on at 9 o'clock last night.
I was trying to look for it the night before.
I was, because I thought it was on Saturday.
Everyone
said
it was, didn't
they? And I couldn't find it everywhere. Yeah, everyone on Facebook was saying it was Saturday, but it was Sunday at 9.
I saw on...
What is this?
Jimmy Savile, Louis Theroux, Jimmy Savile.
This is follow-up.
Follow-up. So he went through old footage, and then he went to the victims, and he kind of pieced it. Because I didn't realise that Louis Theroux, after that, kind of remained the friendship. And he hung out with him, he'd come to his flat, and he kind of like liked him a bit. And so Louis Theroux was saying that he felt fooled by him.
It's a bit like
trapped by him.
What's his name with Michael Jackson?
Michael Bashir.
Yeah, a bit like that. The have you seen the first one?
No.
So basically it was like
just classic
15
Louis
years
Theroux.
Ago, 10 years ago. It was just a Louis Theroux meets.
He was creepy in that.
Jimmy Savile.
Anyway, wasn't he?
Yeah,
it was creepy.
Back in the day, there was no like sniff. It was where the BBC were covering it.
There were rumours, because like in the old Louis Theroux documentary with him, he kind of said like, what about these
there
things
were rumors
the papers
about,
are saying?
There were rumours about him wanting to have sex with dead people, I think.
Ah, what?
Or something like that, because I think he used to work in a morgue at some point.
Oh, he's creepy. I mean, they had some of the victims on, and they would say like, this one account is really disturbing, to be fair, but it's what happened. Like, he preyed on like children's hospitals, so he'd give like £2 million or
I've
whatever,
heard about this.
Loads of money to children's hospitals. So he thought that they owed him a favour. Anyway, this one girl said, "Oh, she was an orphan," and he might have known that by looking at the records. Anyway, she was sat on the end of a bed, and there was a window, and she could see Jimmy Savile with all these other kids running, like because he loved running past. And he looked into the window and saw her, and they clocked eyes, and she saw him. And then he just fucking looked like a madman, stared her in the eyes and ran towards the window. Just ran across his field, ran. All these other kids running, carried on. And he just ran, jumped through the window because it was on the ground floor, ran, grabbed her face and just stuck his tongue down her face.
What the fuck?
And he was going like, "You're a naughty girl, aren't you? You're a bad girl. You've been really bad and naughty." And she said it was horrific. Just his long tongue down his throat.
Oh, my God.
And she's saying that's the kind of guy he was. And he was into
that makes me feel really uncomfortable.
Yeah, I know. But, I mean, he got away with it for fucking, well, all his life.
Yeah, because the fucking revenue that guy was bringing in for the BBC.
For the BBC.
They were just letting kids get mauled. Which is
but they were probably denying it.
They were denying it
in their head, weren't they? They were justified, like, oh no. Because he actually, Louis Theroux went to this woman who was like in charge of that show back in the day.
Can I just say one thing? Yeah, the first one, because we kind of missed out the first bit because they haven't seen the first one. The first one is just literally him interviewing him. And it was no one.
I think I've seen clips.
Yeah,
like,
and they just hang out with him for a week. Yeah. And he wanted to get something out of him. Because everyone kind of knew he was a bit weird. And no one really knew his sexual preference. Not that that's anyone's business. But he's never really had girlfriends or boyfriends. But he'd always like drop hints of certain things. So he kind of like wanted to get something out of him. And I think Louis felt really unsuccessful at that first one, didn't he? Because he was really cold the whole time. And after, when they were off camera, he admitted to Louis to have sex with a 15-year-old girl, which he told the BBC, and it was never looked up after.
Why did he admit that? Like, why would you admit that?
Well, he always kept inviting Louis for a drink off camera, didn't he?
In this latest one.
Why would you say that?
In this latest one, he was saying, like, apparently Jimmy Savile himself quoted saying something like a serial killer. Oh, I wish I knew the quote. I'm shit remembering. Like, a serial killer can only be appreciated from his work when he's found out. Do you know what I mean? And he was saying, like,
so he's a madman then,
so he was kind of like, yeah, Jimmy Savile said that. So he was like, Jimmy Savile was, he was a mastermind at this like sex ring, but no one was appreciating how good he was at this sex ring because no one knew. But then if people found out, he would get arrested. So we dropped sly little hints. Do you know what I mean? It's the same as what serial killers do.
Well, this was Theroux's kind of like metaphor.
Yeah, I think it was Louis Theroux's metaphor. But no, but he was just like looking back to what Jimmy Savile was like and what he said. And Jimmy Savile said to him in his first documentary about this serial killer quote. So he's then like reminiscing and trying to piece things together.
I'll have to watch. I was really looking forward to the second one. I can't believe I missed that.
It's good, yeah, watch it. I mean, to be fair, I fell asleep after about 45 minutes, so missed the last 15.
I can't wait until we see Louis Theroux's new one about Scientology.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We got like a whole ass row. How many is that? 12 of us? We just commandeered the back row.
Oh, that's my pizza, by the way.
What, is it pizza takeaway?
Yeah, got Dominic.
Pizza!
Oh, I haven't had Domino's in ages because I've been like on a proper strict diet, but I had one on Friday. No,
mate, last
Saturday.
2 weeks I've just been so lazy.
Really?
I just can't be arsed. Like, I get in and I just lock myself in my computer. You know what Libby's like? She just snacks on like crisps and stuff. So I was like, can't be bothered to cook. So I've literally just been.
Mate, that's what I'm like all the time.
Yeah.
At the minute, I've been eating sandwiches and toast.
Really? You're just embracing it.
Yeah, mate.
I've been living off like peanut butter and crumpets.
Because I'm in a fairly new relationship, aren't I? It's been like a year anniversary coming up, mine and Leanne's. And it's just when you get into a relationship, you get all fat.
You get comfortable.
Yeah, it's the fat year. And then you both realise.
After a year and a half, then you look at each other and you're like, fuck. I don't want to touch you anymore.
Half as beautiful as I remember you, Dave.
No, we're not whales. We're just a bit
But everyone does it.
Yeah, yeah. You just get comfy, don't
I
you?
I did. I saw a picture of me the other day and I was scrawny. And then like 2 years later, I just put on
your face.
Real
you're really
skinny.
Gaunt.
Yeah. I was a lanky fuck and then just et. And whilst I was still eating, I was like, well, yeah, my metabolism is amazing. Like, yeah, I'm still really skinny. And then I was like, fuck, actually.
It catches up, mate.
Well,
I was quite thin. And then, bam, I was fat.
Just hits you, mate. Yeah. Just hits you. Talk about exercise. I've been going rock climbing. Has anyone ever been rock climbing before?
I saw that on your face.
I've been loving it.
Yeah, I was quite into it for a bit.
It's
I even
good
got my
fun.
Little certificate with my belay in and I'm doing my knots and stuff.
Oh, really? So like you did it quite well.
Yeah, that, I'm fairly proud of.
Sounds like you're on about the Cub Scouts, not really.
You
got your certificate.
You have to do, to go on like the proper, one of the non-self belay ones. You have to learn how
What is a belay? One of those?
Is that when it kicks in and like.
Yeah, so
you
got like a self
belay
one, which is just like automatic reels you.
That's what
down
I've been
slowly.
On.
Yeah. But if you want to go on the one where someone holds you,
yeah.
Each of you have to do each other, you have to do like a little
course. Yeah, that's where the stage we're at.
Doing like 2 hours. You just have to remember to do the knots and stuff.
Yeah, that's the stage that we're at now. Like the auto relay kicking in thing, which is like an automated, like an
abseil
thing. I ripped my balls into my fucking stomach on the first attempt. And then Laura jumped off like halfway because we went there together as like a little date thing. We're like, let's have a go. So she went up and went, right, just jump off. You're only like a meter up. She jumped off and then just splattered in the wall and went blah, 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 along all the little bumps and the handles all the way down. Then I did it and just like really went for it. She went just like relax and jump back. So I just like jumped right far back. And because it was only like a couple of feet off the floor, it didn't kick in time. So it just went and it like sucked my balls up.
Oh, mate. And that sounds disgusting.
The second time I did it, there was loads of professionals and they were like looking at us because we were like making a bit of a scene. And I like climbed all the way to the top and your ass twitches a little bit when you're at the top and you look down. And then I was like, right, you just got to let go and just trust it. So I was like, okay, I trust it. So I went and I was like, okay, going down. But then my body kind of went almost flat. So when I hit the floor, I was like, my feet hit the floor and I was like running backwards, but now I was running backwards with a wire attached to the wall and just landed it on top of them all.
I tell you what, we'll go together and we'll do the splinter cell shit as well.
The what?
Me and my mate Steve Kemp, he's in the army, used to get all the way to the top and you do like a belay down, but you have to be like horizontal to the floor and you got to walk face down like you're like SWAT team or something.
Oh, that shit. That
shit, my dad
crazy.
Was telling me about this
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, me and Steve used to do it to see how close. It was terrifying.
But you are literally trusting the other person holding you, aren't you?
Oh, I trusted Steve because like he'd done like climbing course in the army and stuff like that. But if anyone else, he let me do it to him.
Fuck
and
that.
I'd learned how to be there about an hour ago.
Shit.
He's just there like, yeah, that's it, lower.
No, but are you holding the whole weight of it or is it the way that the ropes are tied? That you actually can take the pressure off. Do you know what I mean? I'm not holding your whole weight, am I?
Yeah, so like when let's say you're trying to like get to the top and there's like a hard bit or something like that.
Yeah.
I can pull a bit of strength on the rope.
So you're not
and I can help it make it easier for you.
Yeah, so you're not basically because I tried to get over like what would you call it, like a cliff bit. So you go under and then over the top again.
Yeah.
And fuck me, that takes some like upper body strength, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So then, but the auto relay wouldn't kick in then, obviously, until I fall.
No,
but
yeah.
Then Laura could have like held me there while I just readjust.
Yeah, that's the best thing about it. Yeah. Okay, someone can pull a bit slack up. But if you fall, yeah, you can hold someone there.
Yeah.
So that happens. What you got to do is you can never take both hands off. You always feed like one by one, like the rope. And then if you come back this way, it's always out like. Never let go with both hands because it will just slide.
Don't let go, James.
But it's kind of like you'd never do it. Like it's hard to make
those
kind of mistakes.
Is that when you get a rope burn?
Yeah, we get a bit of sore. But you never—it's one of those things that you would never make that mistake because it's so close to messing it up.
Yeah.
Like it's rare to see someone fall off somewhere high.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Like by accident, because like instinct kicks in. If you know what I mean.
Yeah. You know that it's not going to end well.
Yeah.
You know that. Your missus on the other end.
You got to live with that.
Ain't going to go down well.
I murdered her. She said, oh my God. Oh, my back.
And that just reminded me of a funny clip that I watched. It was like, I went to bed like one day in the week last week and I was like, put on Channel 5. I think it was just on, I turned on the TV and it was like, funniest news fail clips. Like some shitty Channel 5 program. And this woman was interviewing like this man and his husband. They were about in their 50s and they were talking about sex and stuff like that. And she was like, oh, do you have regular sex? She's like, no, don't have sex anymore. No. And they were chatting and then she was like, okay. And he says, the only time I got sex is favor fucks.
I've never heard of a favor.
No, I haven't. And then she was like, you can't say that about your wife. She went, oh no, actually, no, I just once a month or once every 2 months I'd let him favor fuck me. And they were like 50. And they're like, oh, never. Favor fuck.
Fred just sat there reading Heat magazine while he's absolutely pummeling her.
Yeah, like a sack of potatoes.
Hurry up!
This favor won't last forever.
How old do you think? No, it'll be all right on the actual clip itself. It's just what we hear, but yeah. How old do you think? How old are you allowed to like have? I say allowed. How old do you think is acceptable to have sex? What age do you think?
Well, continuously through if you like still attracted to each other and like yeah. I don't think you go right. I am 50 today. No more sex until it's your birthday and favor fucks.
But that's one of my straight up honest. As soon as I look at Paget, just nah.
Do you think that when you're old, like 70,
like 90-year-olds, I couldn't? I've heard that's the worst place for STIs.
What?
Like old people's homes is meant to be worse than.
Yeah, no, what? I've heard that, but that's bullshit.
Oh, mate, it's fucking true.
How?
It is like really true.
Why?
They're all drilling each other.
They can't be.
Do you know what's that Louis III one when he's like when he goes to meet the people with like Alzheimer's and stuff, and they're just banging each other like they've all got like different misses. Like in old people's homes.
It's like a sex dungeon for old people.
What do you call like, old people's home? What's the real word? What's the real word for like an old people's home?
Care home.
Sex festival.
Care home sex tapes.
STI.
The care home sex tapes.
You know they exist.
The care home files.
Oh my God, the care home files. Can we start our own porn business called the care home files? No, Rob, I'm with you though. I think throughout your life, I think, but if it's your mum and dad, then my mum and dad only had ever had sex once to have me, as far as I'm concerned.
Like in Kevin and Perry, literally, that's it.
Honestly, that's my Achilles heel. When everybody,
you just go for like, mode.
Yeah, proper.
Hands over the ears, just freak out.
Because I annoy the hell out of my mum, like I dig at her all the time, and she gets really annoyed. And the one thing she knows, she goes,
"Did she do it to
me and your father?" I was like, "Absolutely, shut your mouth."
She actually said something to you, like, "Me and your father had sex last night."
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. You haven't ever walked in on it, have you?
I remember when I was really young. You know, they said they were
Santa?
Wrestling.
Is that
they
you,
said,
Santa?
They said they were wrestling.
Santi?
Santi?
Is that you, Santi?
I just phased out for like 10 seconds. I'm reading about old people's banging. I was eating it.
Santi?
Is that you, Santi?
Okay, so like 54% of men over the age of 70 are still banging.
Yeah, but wow. I bet they're sexually assaulting like the
and only 32% of women over the age of 70.
Of course.
So one woman is probably getting pummeled by a few
six
dudes.
Men.
A few dudes in the home. I'm trying to find the STI thing. It's
do you reckon
quite high.
Sexual harassment's quite high? Like, you're 80, I bet you slap the fucking nurses' asses and shit, don't
I bet. I bet some old people are real fucking
real randy. Yeah, feeling real randy.
I remember seeing this horrible fucking video, this woman going around sucking off old men like years ago. I remember seeing that.
What did you search for that, mate?
I don't know. I think my mate showed me. Definitely didn't search it on my own.
You got any stats on there, Softie?
Do you have 50s, 20s? Okay, so over 50s went up by 22% in 2014.
I want to know about
of chlamydia and syphilis and gonorrhea went up by 22% of people over the age of 70. I have it.
I'm
HIV
guessing.
In Britain from 50s up went over by 12%. So they are absolutely getting absolutely slayed.
Yeah, but like I don't think that you, as a male, your urge for sex or whatever will diminish that much. I think you probably slightly, or yeah, you
a lot of old people do. I think the only reason why it does decrease in men is because I've heard that
your testosterone, right? Surely,
yeah, your testosterone levels go down.
Yeah, you've also got the risk of heart attack as well. You might be like, oh,
and estrogen, estrogen's really common.
What a way to go though? You're having sex, you're pumping it away when you're flipping. When you're like 80, you and you grab your fucking heart. What a way to go! I think that's what I would go.
Oh, I bet they just go for the slow ride, though, don't they?
Steady now.
Talking about like creepy things, I'm gonna segue right into this thing. While I was on holiday, right? I don't know how I come around to this video, but me and Leanne saw this. I don't know how it even came about because we got free Wi-Fi in like Leanne's dad's villa.
Yeah.
And I was looking at a lot of, and I had a lot of time to kill, so I was on YouTube, just chilling in Spain, just. And I saw this guy, this cringy, awful fucking guy talking about his zits and how he's got no problem with them.
Where's this going? I don't like him.
I don't know.
He's really freaking me out. It's disgusting. How do you lead on to this? 266,000 people.
This guy's real big
this.
On YouTube. I don't even
what's
know
he going to start
name
popping
is.
His...
He's not popping him, is he?
No.
I can't watch that shit, dude. Like,
no, he's not popping him.
I don't have
hold
any
on.
Fears, but let me
get you...
They have less zits than me. I have a lot of zits. But the
he's
point
just cringy.
Is that they are not perfect.
Is he from the Black
Their
Parade?
Their skin is not 100% pure.
Was it Jared Leto?
In fact, it may be worse than mine. They may age faster than me, or they may just generally get some kind of horrible disease.
He's like basically
God
speaking
forbid,
out for people who's got zits, and it's like.
And that's just the thing. We're
don't really
all human, guys.
We're all human.
But regardless of that fact, I just want to respond to a couple of the comments, which I will show you. This is my body. Okay, I'm not sitting down.
He's not
when
ripped,
you sit
but
down,
minging.
Your stomach rolls up, makes those little fat things. This is my fucking body.
This is awkward.
What is he
you
doing?
You see it? This is my vegetarian body.
This is so
why
awkward.
Is he shout-
What the fuck is wrong with this guy?
I know, right?
This is my body.
What the fuck?
And half you motherfuckers can only dream of having a body like this.
It's a pretty dope body.
Well, he's just skinny, isn't he?
Well, I don't know. He's pretty ripped, but he's really spotty and really pale. But, like, Why is he screaming this guy, my bunny at me?
This guy's got, this guy's known
is
as
that
like
aimed at me.
I don't know what just happened.
This guy is known as like Onion Speaks, and he's like really massive on YouTube now. He's got like over 2 million subscribers.
Yeah, but it was kind of hypnotic, wasn't it? In the most fucked up way.
Well, lost there. What this the fuck
is what,
was going on?
This is what like brought
me. So out of the blue as well. Boys, watch this quickly.
This is Softie.
No lead up to it.
Softie, you do one.
My body!
Well, this is what led me to make this quick video.
And, what, have you done one?
Have I done one? Yeah, this is me.
No, wait, honestly, you just said you just did this video.
No, I didn't do this video.
Oh, okay.
This
is my body!
This is what led me to do this video, guys.
Dressed as a hula girl.
I could... I'll explain afterwards, but...
Okay.
My mind's telling me no!
Oh. Oh, Dave, that's actually genius.
I instantly thought of it when I was on holiday.
This is amazing.
And you actually did it.
Did you make this?
David!
Did you make that?
Amazing.
Yeah. That is perfect. That is absolutely perfect.
This guy is just begging to go viral, isn't he, Dave?
Isn't he, yeah.
One day.
That's on my YouTube. I've got it like set to private at the minute. But
release that sucker now.
Do it again.
Do it right now.
Play it again and we won't talk.
Spin it back.
Spin it back. Let's get a rewind on this because I was talking over it because I didn't know it was going to be that good.
Oh, cheers, mate. Thanks, mate.
Some of your best work, that.
Cheers, mate. My mind's
telling me no. It's the smile you catch on the second clip. But my body, body's telling me
baby, I don't want to hurt nobody.
Bruh.
Oh, I like that. I like
cheers,
it.
Bruh. Well, I heard, like, literally me and Leanne was pissing us out because I was like, oh, what if I, like, put it to that clip of... what's it? What? Who's R. Kelly, isn't it?
Yeah.
But the thing is, I couldn't get, you know, on the bump and grind video. Yeah. So I wanted to cut it with the actual video itself. So it just cut in all quick.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But on the actual video, it doesn't have the start bit. You know, my mind's telling me no. It just like kicks into the song with him like weird,
oh, really?
seducing this weird
can
woman.
You not just play the track and have it?
Well, that's what I did have. I was playing the track and it was just blank. And I was like, well, I'm going to make some kind of creepy video now.
You could have just had him, those two clips of him and then. Then, oh yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, because that whole bit is not in the video.
Yeah, but he's just fucking weird. Apparently, that guy's he's now got 2 million like subscribers. He just like rants. That's what his whole gig. He just literally just rants.
Yeah, there's people online, dude, that are fucking boring. They do weird shit, and I don't know how the fuck they got so many followers.
They just do, mate. As long as you talk like proudly.
And while we're like, me and Laura were watching. Oh, what was it? We were just watching a program the other night, and it was on about like viral videos and stuff. Do you know how things on YouTube just like lead to one thing and the other? We're into Rocket League at the minute, so then I said, "Oh, let's look on YouTube see if there's like a Rocket actual league and a competition." And there's like a £250,000 like prize, isn't there, for Rocket League, which is crazy.
So what doing? What do you have to do?
No, so basically, I think we turned on Rocket League, and then it said, "Don't forget that the final league is on tonight, and the prize is $250,000." So then we went onto YouTube, and there was a whole arena. So do you know, like basketball or NFL or WWE or UFC, you'll get commentators, the TV replays and all that. It was a huge arena, and it was all just for Rocket League, and they had like three people like that on a panel talking about it and what they're doing.
You've never seen esports of it?
Yeah,
before.
Esports are like that. Like,
yeah, I mean, I've seen like League of Legends and stuff like what you guys
Counter Strike are massive.
Yeah, and I was like, anyway. That then led me on to other videos and stuff. But it led me on to like this YouTuber, gamer YouTuber called Mrs. May. I don't know if you've heard of her. But apparently she's pretty big. Anyway, she's Chinese or Japanese or something. I'm not sure. But anyway, she said, right, I've got an Oculus Rift and I want my parents to have a go on it. Her dad is the most hilarious guy ever. And me and Laura are just literally absolutely pissing ourselves.
What do I need to search?
Yeah, like this is it. If you type in Mrs. May.
How are you spelling May? M-A-I.
M-I-S-S-E-S-M-A-E.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mrs. May. And then parents ride Oculus Rift. Or something like that.
Joe, you know, now we're on the subject of like people who are famous on the internet. I said to you just a minute ago, is she hot by any chance?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, she is?
She is hot. Because well, no, I mean, she's okay. She's some, not ugly.
There's some shallow fucks out there, see. But like...
Is it the top one, Rob?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I got it.
The and they make so you much money out of...
You being hot.
Yeah, being hot.
Yeah,
they make so much money out of just being hot.
What, are you on about Instagram as well?
Oh, no. Well, yeah, they do with that, but I mean, they're like, they're prowling on nerds. Like they go to like Comic-Con and they do like cosplay and they have like Twitch streams and they're like, people chuck money at them. Yeah. They're like, oh chuck mate, me 10 quid.
To have a bit of cleavage out and play games.
Yeah, and mate, they make fucking bucks. You know, my free cams. They all do that for the fucking nerds. Like they like live stream. And well,
I would if I was a girl though.
Yeah, but dude, but to me, man, that's... It's just not the way you make your money in life. Like,
it depends if you've got respect for yourself.
Yeah, which they clearly don't.
Or you see the dollar bills rolling in real fish. Oh, yeah.
They're making fucking bank off like some fucking spotty, ugly dudes we like need us
to get,
three.
We need to get Leanne in here. She'll be fucking triggered about that shit, being a feminist and all that. She'll be like...
Aah! Yeah, it's bad.
Yeah.
It's bad for both sides. It's bad for themselves because they're selling their fucking body.
No, I disagree. I think why not? Like, why shouldn't she? Like, why shouldn't she show it off and make money from it?
It's kind of shallow in a
more
way.
More for the fucking guys are chucking money.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that's what I'm saying. They're prowling on those kind of guys as well. So it's
who's in the wrong there then?
Both.
Well, no. I don't think it's you're a grey. It's a grey area, mate.
Nah, it's fucked up.
I don't like it.
It's almost begging in a way. If you listen to the way they talk, they're like,
"Oh yeah,
hey,
well,
I'm really skinned this month, and
about.
I want to buy the." And they fucking straight
okay,
up
well
say
that's
it.
Just a bit
honestly,
yeah,
they all do.
Yeah. Being beautiful and playing games, you can be beautiful.
They literally just ask
games.
For money. It's fucking real weird. Like I just I don't know.
If you're like I
and they're making bucks,
but that's better than maybe that's better for them to do that than to maybe go on like a television strip show and just like call me tonight and then I like, actually have the other puss out.
But at least, but.
I think
least
it started from them.
At least that's blatant. That's like blatant, and that's you know what you're getting.
Yeah, you know what I mean? These guys are selling sex without giving it.
Whereas,
you know
yeah,
I mean?
Well, they're there for a quick fix. They're not there to promise you anything. Are they? They're not kind of, I'm going to be your boyfriend. This is kind of more what you're saying. It's a bit more like
I think
playing
you,
on your. Like,
I think once you've watched it, dude, like you'll kind of be like.
Yeah.
Like, cause what I'm saying is doesn't sound that bad. I'd be like, oh, okay, they're just hot girls online playing games. I don't think anything.
No, the begging
wrong with
thing.
There's
was
some
a
great
bit
streamers,
weird.
And they just happen to be
if
hot.
If they're taking advantage of like,
but listen, to, yeah,
like kid, well, like
it's like the Amazon shopping lists.
When they're
like
they're clearly
Amazon
not
list.
Making their photo shoots for FHM, if you know what I mean. So they're kind of like, I'll go to Twitch or I'll go to one of these cam websites, and they go to like all the cosplay, like fucking Comic-Con and stuff like that, and they're just making pee just from. And then they kind of have the cheek, which is the worst thing, to act or film. It's like, I hate it when the other guys are just looking at you. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I can see the edge of your asshole in those fucking in that fucking pair of pants, love.
Mate, you're selling it.
Oh, mate, there's nothing wrong with it. I think it's fucking awesome. What I'm just saying is that they can't turn around after that and be all feminist about it after their fucking... Starfish is winking at me like fucking miles away.
Yeah, if they're taking advantage of like these kids' feelings, like as in, you know, you're a young
expect loads of dudes to be getting
16, 17 year old and they're getting bonus and even but are they promising them the world? Do you know what I mean? I'm gonna be your I'll be your boyfriend. If
he's
like
God,
playing
he's
on
him.
Their emotions more rather than just selling themselves. They're playing
like hi guys, thank you for donating.
A bit like strippers, how they prey on these desperate men and some men like think they're generally good out.
Oh,
I see some
that,
awkward
that Louis Theroux one's awesome.
That one. Oh, you're about to say that bloke who's in love with that.
Yeah.
And he just Rob.
He's proper in love with her.
Yeah, I don't think I know that
check
one.
So, Rob, before we go stray far too
much. Oh, yeah. What? So, but you might want to skip on a little bit to when her dad comes on, which is, I think, like, just under halfway. It was just his reaction. Well, we're talking, like, gamers and YouTubers and stuff like that. So, basically, it's this...
So if I skip through it,
yeah, skip through it till you see the dad come on. I think the mum comes on first. It's basically the Oculus Rift. Here it is. Yeah, go back a bit.
Oh, sure.
And he doesn't understand that it's not real.
Oh, bless
what
him.
What do you mean he doesn't understand?
Well, just watch it. It's really cute. So she's like, showed her mum, and her mum's really enjoyed it. And the dad's like, he wants to go. And it's like Minecraft, and it's going up a roller coaster, and it's got dips and troughs and stuff.
The Minecraft one's really good. I played a beta on my Oculus the other day, but...
Right, here we go. The dad's on.
What? His dad just doesn't understand.
It's like really holding on to the chair for dear life.
No one is you, motherfucker.
He's saying, I don't want you this. I don't want this, you motherfucker. I don't want this. I can go close my eyes.
What the hell is not shit. That real, though, is it?
His little sword.
Is he gonna have a fucking
heart attack? I don't want this, Jonah.
No, 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 no.
No. So cute.
It's cute.
Oh shit!
Oh shit!
What the hell?
It looks like he's in pain, doesn't it?
Softie, can you get this in your Oculus?
I don't know. This
is saying like, ouch.
This is like some
ouch.
Beta dev game thing. Oh, no.
Is he all right?
It's hard.
And he always, he goes again. But he thinks he's going to bang his leg on this. He can't get around his head that it's not real.
Oh, bless him.
The punch noises they've added in.
Oh, shit.
But he looks like he's squirming in pain in his chair. Now, from that, me and Laura then went on to another one of her videos, which was the opening sequence to the Oculus Rift, where they were like, for generations, we've been trying to develop the technology and those screens and stuff. And I think it was like a 10-minute intro into it. And I think that's what you get when you buy it. Have you got it?
Yeah, I've got Oculus, but you didn't get
it. Did it have an intro thing?
No.
Did it not have an intro into the whole like system?
You get this thing that we played with. Is,
like the cinema screen and all that and the TV. Did you not get any of that? Because this was like kind of like a tutorial. It's kind of showing you the Oculus Rift. And it was like, this is what you can do with it. You can watch films in the cinema or you go into your bedroom.
That might be something they just did afterwards. The thing you get with it is like...
Tom's just screaming at us now.
Oh, yeah, because he did say we have spoken about it in nearly every podcast. All right, well, we'll briefly touch on it and then we'll go.
I don't know. No, I just got like... it just showed you like a few cool things in it, which I put Dave in on that thing.
Have you used it much? Or is it a novelty? I'm guessing it's a bit like the Wii, you get it out at parties, and it's a kind of a novelty. Until you get a game that is incredible on it.
It's hard.
Yeah, because you've had immersive. It for quite some time now, haven't you?
Yeah. I.
When was the last time you used it?
I know I would use it more. The only problem is at the
VR
moment...
Porn, right?
No, I genuinely don't even use it that much. I tried it. It's actually shit. The VR porn is terrible. I'm not sure if you watch any like other podcasts people talking about this kind of crap and everyone raves about it and stuff
no.
like that. But the VR porn is dog shit. Those 360 cams are dog shit. The quality is dog shit.
Really?
It's like jumping back when we had it on a fucking old Walkman phone and it was like the pixelated as fuck.
We had a PlayStation 1 game on a disc.
Porn's terrible.
On the PSP. Yeah.
I think now recently I've started using it more now because I started to find practical applications for it rather than using it for games.
What do you mean, like?
Like, I can watch movies in it. I can, like, in a big cinema screen, like, on the fucking moon if I want to. Or there's a cool social thing where you can watch films with randomers. You just chat to random people about cool films and stuff like that, which I did the other week, which is awesome. You can just sit in there and join a public living room. So I was explaining this to Dave the other day about... I'm sure it's Dave. I was talking about how you could go in... I've got a living room in this thing that comes with Oculus, and I can project my monitor on the big screen in there, and I can make it open, and people can just join if they want to, and you can all have your own little monitors in front of you and just do your work and watch a film in my living room if they want,
the
or
fuck?
Outside, or
so you create your own workspace.
Yeah, and I went in one the other week where this guy was using a 3D software that I like to use, and he had like three people sat along and next to him, and they've all got their faces, and when you talk, their mouse augmented. I could see their monitors, and he had his up there, and he was teaching people how to do a certain 3D thing for, he was basically creating some kind of machinery, because he works in like more the industrial world, and they were kind of learning along with him. He's like, oh, that's quite interesting, let me have a go at that. And then I just sat down, and I booted up, and he went, oh, you're right, Ben. I was like, you're right. He's like, yeah, join us if you want. And I was just like, okay.
Now you are living in a different world here.
Yeah, and I just...
That's weird. That is the future.
3DS Max, and I was just there, just...
It's like me and you, Rob, getting in a room and looking at Photoshop, and you're like, dude, I've drawn this thing, and I come in and go, oh yeah, that's cool.
Oh my god! So you're sat there, and you're not actually in this realm. You're in this place, and you've created this like landscape around you. And like you said, you can be in this workspace.
Your desktop's
outside.
Projected up there, and we can all have our own floating desktops. I can make it bigger, larger, smaller, whatever. And I can just follow along with him, or I can go, oh, have you seen this video? And I can make mine bigger. and like you just have conversations with random people. But it was like educating people as well. So you could have virtual classrooms now. Like,
can you imagine the escapism for say someone who's in like a deprived house? They might not be able to get an Oculus Rift.
We said about this, yeah.
But then, yeah, I mean, to recreate your surroundings and go to this special place that's really nice and happy
for
and
disabled people and shit. Like, yeah, for people like, who can't walk.
Yeah, or go see the world. Yeah. Like, wow, that is just insane, isn't it? It's crazy where they're going to
go. I don't know why they haven't
this.
Made an affordable VR headset, which is basically just all the basics that you need to play all this stuff. Because the phone does it, the Samsung. You just slide it in behind the two lenses.
How
it's
good
not
is
as
that?
Good. It's not as good. It's good, but it's not as good. But the thing I
was going to buy one just
get
to
rid of all the extra stuff that we really don't need for it and just trim it down to the screen, the processor, the battery life. And then this could be now be more affordable, a cheaper version that you could just chuck in old people's homes where they can, like, I don't know, do like awesome experiences and
VR porn. Because they're all horny, motherfuckers.
You could strip that down to like £200. Less than that. I reckon you could do it for like £150. Those screens are dirt cheap. The battery life on them is like, if it was just solely for that, the battery life would be really long. So, actually, we might look into making one of those suckers.
Mate, you can pick don't announce up. On the podcast. People have no idea.
Which I will have.
Are you taking
patented
that
patented by now, patent, motherfuckers.
Patent. Can't take it.
Yeah.
Verbal contract between you and yourself on this podcast.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah, just steering it away from VR before Tom loses his shit.
Yeah.
YouTube. You heard about this YouTube Heroes?
No.
Oh my God. It's like the biggest thing that's happening in YouTube at the minute. And it happened while I was away. For content creators, it's very bad news. YouTube has made this thing. Create this thing called YouTube Heroes, and basically they're crowdsourcing like monitoring their videos to become a YouTube hero. So basically you get points, it's like a point system, and basically you
snitches.
Go up ranks
yeah stitches
so you get points for good the good pros are you get points for you know, subtitling the video. So say one of our videos, our podcast, wanted subtitling, someone have to sit there and type it all out, you get points for that, which is a good thing.
That's quite cool. Yeah.
And then you move up the ranks and then you get also get points for reporting videos, and I think this is where it gets dodgy, man. And that it's got I think it got the most dislikes ever on a YouTube video. I want to say that I've said that out loud, but it was up there, man. Like all the content creators, like all the big ones, like PewDiePie and everybody, are literally slagging this off.
Because YouTube and Twitch are becoming a bit, and Twitter are becoming a bit Gestapo, aren't they?
Yeah.
Like you can't say this. Like they're kind of ruling what people say now.
Yeah.
I don't like that.
It's basically. Yeah. I mean, and they're treating it like a game. So when you reach like level 4, I think, I'm gonna have to
gamification. I'm learning about this at the moment.
Level 1, here we go. Become a hero, 0 to 9 points. Join the community. Then you access level 2 when you get 10 to 99 points.
But what's the benefits?
So
becoming this hero,
you just nothing. When you get to level 5, you get close up to 1,000 points. Test products before they release and apply for the Hero Summit. So you get invited to a. So basically, you're like snitching. You get points right for like flagging videos. And when you get to stage 3,
weird.
Here we go. Level 3, mass flag abusive videos. So you can sit there and click.
So it's basically getting people to do their dirty work.
Yeah, and you're getting anybody. So trolls.
It's like open sourcing, isn't it? Open source was a great idea, wasn't it? For like. Developing and stuff like that, but now they're trying to get people to do their some people call dirty work, but it's more like a labor
like
now, isn't
snitching
it?
Man, it's labor like work, hallway yeah. Monitor bullshit, and people I saw it and I was like, this is fucking weird. So you could like get access to the hero's dashboard, so you get your own little dashboard to snitch on people. And
gosh.
When you get to level 3, like mass flag, I've had a video flag that went viral, that my mum one, right? Yeah. 80,000 hits in one night. We went rock climbing that next day, and I remember saying, shit, it's been taken down because someone just flagged it without even, I mean, fair enough, right? YouTube,
they must have analyzed it and then taken it down because.
But YouTube don't have, I get they have millions upon millions of videos uploaded a day. How are you going to manage that?
Yeah.
But I just don't think crowdsourcing is a fucking good idea because you've just got any
yeah,
old
Yeah, because
Tom
it, comes, it becomes opinionated. Then it depends on whether, if it gets flagged, does it get sent to YouTube? And do they check it out
no,
afterwards?
Not really. I got mine flagged and it just got taken down without me even like contesting
this
it.
This is a little bit of my problem with, sorry, going back to games, but you know CSGO when you have the Overwatch?
Yes.
CSGO.
So Overwatch is like a viewing thing where you can see who. So you basically so monitor the game.
Yeah, me and Dave are playing against you. We think something dodgy about what you're doing. So we report you to hacking or aim hacking or war hacking. We think something's dodgy about you anyway. Someone who's been given access to Overwatch will watch the video of the whole game back of that player.
Oh my god.
And so anyone in the community. And it's kind of similar to that, like
a bit, but you have to really work your ass off to get
Overwatch account. But the thing is with the Overwatch thing is anyone can just ban you without any knowledge really.
Yeah.
Of like what a hacker might be doing. I've seen people I've watched like a video on YouTube of someone doing Overwatch and I just thought, actually, I think they're just really good. You're watching a global here, like that's quite the highest rank. And they were just going, nah, I think they're hacking. I completely disagree with his video. I thought, I just think that guy's really good at the game. Mm. And he just went, yeah, hacking. And that gets him banned. Mm. Like that, just someone random.
That's opinionated again, though.
Yeah, you can't do that. So if YouTube are doing it like...
YouTuber, like, it's even worse, man.
If YouTube are doing it like that, they just go,
what's really dodgy about it is YouTuber making it a game. Like, you get points.
I was learning about this at uni. It's gamification.
They're gamifying being a snitch, which is a very fucking dangerous thing to do.
Yeah, Facebook did it for a while,
didn't they? Get points for, like, you know, reporting. So, like, kids are just going to be like, oh, wicked. They're going to treat everything as a game.
But they can't just, like, flag someone up and then they get taken down. Because they must expect that some kids are just going to press anything just to get these points. So it can't really... They must look at it deeper once it's flagged. Otherwise, everyone just flag everything.
But anyone can flag anything. So why give them the hero?
Yeah, but they can't look at every. Could you imagine looking at every single video? YouTube can't employ enough people because there's death videos still on YouTube that shouldn't be on there because they can't get rid of them. Like beheading videos, if you really look deep at YouTube, because
really?
You can't. Yeah, if you can't get because you can't get rid of every. You can't monitor that shit. So that's why I can see why the crowdsourcing it is a very bad.
I think maybe
this
should be like
way. And you're not even getting paid for this shit either. You're just getting, you're going up levels. You're getting points, like level one. You get all the way to level five, mate, and you get to test products before they release and apply for the Heroes Summit.
I think it...
Which is like a summit of snitches where you just
I think
get
there
together.
Should be a level of like rules. Like, if it's something like gore, yeah, you can flag that shit.
Or like
I think
sex.
When it comes to like someone not saying, I would say anything like this, but someone just goes, I just think that guy's a stupid homo or something like that. Like, you can't
that's
really...
That's what you're going to get.
Yeah, you can't... As much as I agree, you can't say that kind of thing. But they're the kind of things where people are going to start getting annoyed. Like,
but even YouTube have really like struck the hammer down on their like policies. You're not even allowed to swear in videos.
The monetized thing as well.
You can't swear anymore.
The monetizing.
You can't really, mate. I don't think you can even swear.
Oh, fuck up! I get Twitch because Twitch is kind of like
you just said. Fuck. Now we cut. That's it. If we wanted to make.
Fucking loads of fuck.
If we wanted to make like money off this video, which we don't monetize our videos, but it might be something we'd do in the future. I don't know. Well, I don't know.
I'd
but
be out.
So you'd censor yourself.
Yeah, but I wouldn't censor myself. I'd be like, fuck it, we'll make.
Is this what all the YouTubers are on about? Like monetizing.
YouTubers are like really like. There's a big one. I can't remember his name.
They're all talking about it. So I see it coming up.
Yeah. But this other guy's laid out his structure so he doesn't really get the majority of his money from YouTube. He gets it from elsewhere. So he wasn't really that bothered. So he's like, look, I'm saying. Yeah. But
they don't pay you if you're swearing in a video.
Yeah, they don't. You're not allowed to monetize your video. I mean, it's just, and they've got really strict on the law. I think if they keep fucking up this much, I reckon you're gonna see the rise of another video,
another stream, like
another
yeah,
stream
another,
video
server. Yeah,
and you can't
platform.
Imagine that because YouTube's the biggest.
Well, can you imagine time without YouTube? Can you imagine what we did without YouTube? That's crazy to think YouTube wasn't kicking about. Like, I probably used YouTube more. Then I was going to say more than Facebook. I mean, me and you were just talking about how addicted we are to Facebook without even realizing, and how
mate,
much of a human
phone,
instinct it is to just flip.
I can't
on
go
Facebook.
To the toilet without.
That's exactly what we said outside.
Yeah, we were saying like if you
we were saying
go to the toilet and you forget your phone, you turn
you,
around,
you go back.
No, even if I'm at like the fucking deucey is on the edge of my boxer shorts, I will go back.
And
that.
It's like
definitely, I'm the same.
But it's pathetic because like I'll flick on my Facebook app, even though it bores me to death now, and then I'll look and I'll go past like the next 10 kind of posts, and then I'll automatically 2 minutes later get my phone out, go on to that, refresh it, and then just look at the last two. And it's like, why? I don't even care.
Stupid.
But my body and my brain, it releases endorphins, and you kind of like want to see a notification.
You can't help it.
I heard on the radio the other day when I was driving to Holland, it said over 50% of 18 to 25 year olds are checking their phone in the middle of the night when they wake up. Facebook, like social media.
Is that what?
You wake up like 3 in the morning.
They can't sleep. Like, because they want to see what's on
the
phone.
No, no, no. They just wake up and, like, rather than just rolling over and go back to sleep, they go, I'll have a look at Facebook quickly.
Here, look.
Fuck.
Look.
What's this?
This is YouTube Heroes. Look, this is the...
I look at Facebook in the morning before I eat my breakfast.
This is the video that came out. Let me just make sure it's on.
But you're not meant to look at your phone an hour before you sleep, because then you're doing it a proper night's sleep.
Yeah.
This is it, look, Rob. This is the campaign they did for it. So you work hard, and like all heroes, you deserve a place to call home. Welcome to YouTube Heroes. So at the start, right, it kind of like...
This is so propaganda.
Gain points when you... Add captions. This is a good one, right? Add captions to videos. Brilliant. You should get rewarded for that. What? Or share knowledge with others. So yeah, reporting and sharing it with others.
Level they kind of brushed over the report.
Yeah, they just brush over it. Level one, become a hero. Access to the hero dashboard. Join the community. Level two, continue your training. And then, like, learn more at exclusive workshops.
This is bizarre.
Take part in hero video chats. So snitches get together and chat about it. Unlock super tools at level three. Here we go. This is the concerning one. Mass flag videos. Yeah, report.
Oh, my God. It's literally just trying to fucking run over.
Help moderate content. Level four, go behind the scenes. Ooh.
So you're basically working for them, aren't you?
Yeah, but for no money, by the way. You're just getting a point system. Yeah, level five, access to the top hero perks.
This is a bit Scientology, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit like a cult. Everyone's saying that. It's fucking scary.
It's really, really.
Yeah, that's...
There's something
that's
quite
bizarre.
American about it as well, with the colours. It kind of reminds me of...
Just take a look at the dislikes.
Like a vote campaign.
Read that dislike out.
Yeah. It's, that is really propagandary.
Read that dislike out.
Oh, right.
That's that. What is that?
800,000 people dislike that video. How many people like it?
26,000.
And it's had, what, 3 million views?
Yep.
God, that's crazy. What's PewDiePie had to say about it?
You know, I just said it's really propagandry. Look at the one up there with the swastika on.
Which one? Oh, that one. Yeah, people are pulling it apart.
Oh, I bet they are.
Typing like Russian civil propaganda, like on Google or something. It's those same kind of colours and stuff.
Propaganda?
You know, like communist propaganda.
Yeah, we watched that.
Look, like the red.
Yeah, it is very much like that.
Do you know what I mean? Those kind of like washed out colours and everything's a bit blocky. Kind of reminds me of that, like.
Ooh.
And like fucking Nazi. No. Yeah. Snitch on the evil people on the internet!
But aren't you just going to get like, say,
because he had an opinion on feminism?
Like, if you're falling out, your mate's doing really well on YouTube and your channel's really shit, and you get fucking pissed off and you fall out of each other because he's getting more views than you. But like, flag him. It's just going to turn real petty and real like.
It will get petty, won't it? Yeah.
So I don't know. It might work.
I'm
sure they've thought about this.
That's what I thought. I thought, surely
they've thought about this. They won't just go in blind. Like
it
that,
to me sounds
say.
Like they haven't thought about it.
They're getting
it.
Some well, major benefits
well,
out of this.
Comments
somewhere.
Are disabled on that video, by the way.
Really?
Of course they fucking
are. Of course
are.
They are.
YouTube have disabled comments.
Yeah.
Oh, mate. Well, that's me fucking done.
You're out.
I'm out.
I'm out.
I'm not on this podcast
I'm
anymore.
Done.
I'm done. See you later.
Well, if this podcast... I'm over it. If this podcast ever made it big, we wouldn't be going on YouTube money anyway. It'd be like podcast advertising on the
and mugs, selling mugs,
and selling mugs.
These
baby.
Are incredible mugs, by the way.
They're actually decent.
How much
quality
would
as well.
We sell these for?
I don't
I'm
know.
Not sure how much they
that's
cost.
Good.
But
yeah, put it there. Hey, put a little thumbs up next to it, Rob, because I want to take a still of that. Get a thumb there. There you go. Good.
Can you see my thumb?
Yeah. Look at that. Hold on, boys.
Take a still. Oh yes.
There you go. Have a look, Rob. Yeah, I like
that. You're taking
that.
A still.
Look at the fucking, look at the camera, Rob.
Which one, that one?
Yeah, boy.
That can be.
Well, we'll see. We'll see how.
That can be our thumbnail. Mugs galore,
mate. Just before we go, because we'll wrap this up in a minute.
Yeah, boy.
Well, can I get back to what I was saying?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Go on.
I cannot believe YouTube has disabled people saying something about their work.
Just it, mate.
You cannot say anything about what we do.
Black it, flag it.
If you're dictate anything we say, we will burn your children.
I mean, honestly, they invented the comment box.
I'm sorry for being very racist to some lovely German people out there. That was me referring to Nazis.
Well,
Germans.
Nazis and Germans are very two different things.
Yeah. It's just like Muslims and terrorists.
Muslims
are two
and
different.
Teletubbies.
And sunshine.
All Muslims are terrorists.
Yeah, YouTube invented the comment box, so that is quite hilarious.
YouTube invented
quite
YouTube,
ironic.
That, it's been really common recently. What's that?
Imagine if it got
that poet that Jim really loves. He talks about chocolate cake and no breathing that Jim loves. No breathing. You're not seeing it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't nice. Remember.
Nice.
I can't remember.
I'll send that. He ain't for the podcast.
No, it is. We'll get that. We'll save that one. We'll get it for Rob later.
Yeah. It's so
before we move on and probably wrap this up, I just want to say one of his comments. About. Is it really?
Because he just gets loads of shit.
Well, I would. I'll
be fucking yeah, turn that shit off.
Who's excited for UFC, the new one?
205, that motherfucker is going to absolutely
destroy. I really enjoyed the conference this again. Exactly. It's like, who's this motherfucker? Who's this motherfucker behind me? He never fails.
Who do you think you'd struggle with the most or something like that?
And he's like,
I'm the hard pound for pound hitter. I always knock people out. This guy just gets TKOs and he's like, it's where he's like, he doesn't look at him straight away. He's like, where's it coming from?
Yeah,
like,
who the fuck is this guy?
Who the fuck is this guy?
Who the fuck is this?
I mean, I can't do a fucking Irish, but Conor McGregor.
Oh, he's just a genius. And then did you see that that meme video that I shared when it was like Dana White and then it zoomed into Dana White's face and then it had a flashback and it went to when Conor McGregor threw all the bottles of water. Then it went back to the present time and then you just saw Dana White come over and take the bottle of water away from him.
He took the can, didn't he?
Well, then I would suggest anybody's listening to this, the 9-minute video, if you're into UFC, even if you're not into
even
UFC.
Not,
you watch
I mean,
the full press conference, amazing, isn't it?
Oh, mate, I didn't need to watch the full one, mate. I just watched 9 minutes.
He's given it back
They still missed a few good bits out of it.
Really?
Yeah.
To be fair, he was giving the chat back to Conor McGregor. He was like, take off your sunglasses then.
Nah.
He was like, no, man.
I don't think he was. I thought it was fucking
weak. Yeah, but other
weak.
People just Conor literally
like,
stood
he
there.
Knows he's going to get pummeled.
Yeah,
who? I'm not a big McGregor. Well, I am a big McGregor fan now. I used to be a bit like, the hype train's a bit too real.
Yeah, but
I kind of
real,
still a bit funny about
awesome.
The Nate Diaz fight. I still think it might be a draw.
Nah.
I think it is a draw.
Nah.
But that he's going to get absolutely.
Is he? Because I know nothing about this other guy. Do you know anything about his opponent?
No.
Neither do I. Tell us a little bit.
Every time McGregor wins, or you know, every time he's won prior to that, you can see his confidence.
What,
like, he's always been a bit calmer around Nate Diaz, isn't he?
Mm.
Whereas, like, we've seen this, like, McGregor before, where he's like, I'll eat this guy for breakfast.
Yeah.
Where he's apprehensive about Nate
and
Diaz.
And he will.
Anyone would be.
Yeah, he wasn't
about Nate
sure.
Diaz. The guy has half a fucking brain cell running in his mind.
Yeah.
He just doesn't feel pain, man.
Yeah. His cardio is after. I can't do it.
And he does like, decathlons and shit for, like, the morning run.
They've just got it in their jeans.
Oh, yeah. He's just so fit and like.
So, Softie, is this other guy got. He hasn't. I've heard he hasn't got.
Friggin' name.
Good cardio is fucking.
So, why have they picked him? Why is Dana
Conor McGregor picked him?
Conor McGregor picked him.
Because Conor was
I don't know. I don't know. I think Dana called him for it, didn't he?
But why is that then? Has he been shouting out saying that you can beat him? Is he good? Is he a good fighter? Have you seen his other fights?
No, yeah. He's a fucking awesome fighter. I just think that.
I've heard he's just got a weak chin.
I just think that McGregor will absolutely dominate him. I just know he will.
I hope he does because Conor McGregor, his confidence is through the roof at the minute. And what I liked about McGregor is that I was unsure he'd beat Nate. And he came back and learned from his mistakes because he obviously lost to Nate first. And when he came back for his rematch, he learned by his mistakes and played a very, very smart game.
Yeah, people said he was running away. Like, but he wasn't.
Of course you would.
But the, sorry, I couldn't remember fucking Eddie's first name. There we go. I think it was Alvarez.
Eddie Alvarez, yeah.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, he is a fucking good fighter, but McGregor is going to be an accurate little sniper with that
lefty.
Yeah.
I thought he looked incredible at the Nate Diaz fight, to be fair. His cardio lacked a little bit in the third.
I just don't think he'll ever get up to Diaz's cardio. It's hard. For Diaz's cardio.
He's
so
athlete.
The guy can just eat like sip loads of beers on the weekend now because his heart is so healthy.
Yeah,
like he can just eat shit.
But Conor's
like,
got
for a year and still be fit, whereas McGregor's
he's got precision, like he says.
He's about power and stuff
speed.
Like that. Whereas that
speed
guy
beats power.
I don't think people understand how fit people are that do like triathlons and stuff. Like you are a machine.
Yeah. Have you seen Sean Conaway? Big ginger hair, big ginger beard. He quit his life. His missus left him. And he's got two series, actually, on Sky. Discovery, absolutely incredible guy. But he's just done a triathlon all the way around the UK. But he biked half of it, swam half of it, and run the other bit. All the way around the UK with sleeping rough, self-supporting. No one was allowed to help him. And when he swam for like 4 or 5 hours a day and had like a little boat with all his gear in it, and then went on the beach and just laid on the rocks. Incredible guy. Good documentary. Sean Conaway. And you can follow him on Twitter. He just takes a phone with Twitter on it, like a special phone, and you can tweet him and just like say, well done. Really humble, amazing guy. It's worth a watch. Sean Conaway is cool.
That's
very cool.
Yeah.
Very cool guy. He does really plugging cool it. Shit. Yeah, plugging him.
I was like, shit, does he work for this guy? Just to go back to
McGregor's.
You
got a new job?
Yeah. Just to go back to McGregor's quote, his actual quote is, yeah. Precision beats power and timing beats speed.
Wow. This is why he's just a great, great theatrical person.
Precision beats power.
Yeah, yeah. Which is right, because he placed him on the chin.
Yeah.
With that 13-second knockout.
Unless your jaw is Nate Diaz.
Yeah. Because Nate didn't go down for shit.
So then he just had to power through.
You need
he?
Power yeah, for that guy.
When is when
you
is
actually
the,
need power.
When is UFC? Is it 205?
It's on the 8th of November.
Is it that late?
Pulled it out of my arse. I think it was November. I'm not sure. But isn't there Bisping soon? The UK
Bisping.
Guy.
Bisping?
Oh, Bisping.
I don't like Michael Bisping. Just does my nutting. He's so cocky and not very humble.
November 12th, guys, 2016.
Oh, it's not 12. Far off. Not far off.
I believe that's a Saturday, isn't it? November 12th.
It will be. It's a Saturday. Stupid o'clock.
Saturday night.
Well, it's New York, so what's the time difference in New York?
Should we all get on a plane?
They're
usually
in like Vegas, aren't they?
Oh, I'd love it. Mate, in a year's time, if I'm absolutely raking some ball of money in for some kind of reason, I'll take us all to Las Vegas and we'll go watch Conor McGregor. How's that?
That'd be sick.
I'm just looking up ticket prices.
If he hasn't been absolutely dropped three. Millions of times.
I would love him to win every single fight for like the next year and it'd been this like absolute god figure.
Called out Floyd again, didn't he, in that conference?
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
I would guess so.
What, a ticket?
Where's
500?
Row one? Where's row one?
Dude, I'm not kidding. The tickets to UFC are disgusting.
Really?
Dude,
really?
If you
even
sit,
for a standard
if you
seat.
If you want to get up
in the balcony.
High.
Yeah,
what, like a
barely see with some fucking...
I'll let you guys read these out.
Yeah.
What, cheap seat ticket?
Yeah, these are disgusting. Okay, so...
So the cheapest one is that? $900
yep.
for the cheapest seat miles away from the actual...
Is this 205? Yeah, but don't forget these are now stupidly expensive.
So you're going into the green now. What is?
So what's the greens if you wanted a real good seat? What's that? Cause I can't
yellows,
see
I'm guessing, is the
green
best
is like, seat. Yeah, sort of WWE distance. You so know what I mean? Where like
so how much are one of those bob boys? Because so I can't see it.
Well, if you scroll over green, it'll... So oh, there's 1,146.
Yeah, keep going because I want to see
click
the
on
yellow.
Yellow, mate. You'll be mind blown. Yellow is disgusting.
Ringside almost.
Find like eight.
That's like celeb. Scroll down.
£7,000.
No.
Click on that 8F again.
Where's 8F?
There. These price from $7,270.
So that's
holy
like
what?
Shit.
Still like $6,000.
$6,000. Wow.
They're cheaper than normal because I remember when me and
what
my
about
mate
Joe Rogan see where he commentates? How much for that one? And he just Joe What's Rogan that? Just invites his mates, doesn't he?
Yeah.
I remember looking back to back when like Chuck Liddell and stuff were like huge, the old school fighters. Me and Ad looked at front row tickets and they were like $25,000 or something like that.
What's the balcony price? Is that quite dear? Cause I'm
guessing
it's
still
like
expensive.
A booth.
They're still expensive.
Mate, I guess it's like a booth or something. There, that pink one.
Which pink one?
Top.
Oh, there.
How much is that? Is that like a...
1,000.
The Chase Bridge. It's 1,000.
Nice.
Fucking hell, boys. I think that's one of my dreams, mate. To
that'd be cool.
Either go to the Ali Pali, which is probably more affordable to watch the darts. To watch the film.
That'd be hilarious.
I've always wanted to go to the darts.
I know someone invited me the other day, but I was like, well, where's this come from? I didn't know you're a darts fan. So, yeah, people like darts.
And on that note. get the guitar out. Let's sing us out for episode 13. Go on, Rob. Pull that little fucking boy.
I'll get my... guitar mic back out.
Right, we're going to say goodbye for episode 13. Thanks for joining us. We hit the hour, 1 hour, 23 mark.
Right, I'm just going to riff this, baby.
Right, riff it, Rob. Yeah, put that more towards you, Rob. Point the flipping thing towards you, mate.
Oh, like baby, this. I like it raw. Oh, baby.
Oh, that was completely
that was disgusting.
Tune.
He's just going to riff it.
Right, okay, I'm going to go pop punk for this.
I'm
named Rob Swain. Look at me now with my dirty glasses on my fucking brow. My face is dirty, my ass is clean. Motherfucker, oh, and you'll be me. Yeah!
Oh, 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 Yucky Duck Show.
Everyone that wants to be me. Yeah! I'm Rob Swain, motherfucker.
Yucky Duck Show, it's a Yucky Duck Show. It's all fun, it's a Yucky Duck Show. Welcome to the Monday Show. The Yucky Duck Show, it's a Monday Show. And yo, thank you for tuning in, my friends. We all love you very much. Yeah. We love you.
This is Rob Swain, boy.